How you doing it, folks? This is Bradshaw Studios coming right at ya. I've had computer problems, and I fixed them. And I'll see you right after the credits. This is Bradshaw Studios coming right at ya, folks. How you doing, folks? We're gonna move my photos tonight. Enjoy. That's too bad about those two, the World Trade Center. Sad, sad, sad. I'm going to be listening to a book. There won't be, I mean, you will hear me talking, but you won't hear the book. I just did a test on it.
A visitor to gradually leave the world below behind. There was a vehicular road, a bit wider and paved also, but it was on the other side of the mountain and sealed off. Used only by the convent to bring up supplies. It bothered him that he hadn't been able to speak with Kelsey. But he had to remind himself that she was in another world now. One with its own ways and rules, both of which he had to respect. At least she was safe, out of danger. He'd contacted Reynaldo after Sister Claire had fled and explained the situation, accepting full responsibility for his own gullibility. This is turning ridiculous, Reynaldo had said. Perhaps we should end this now. You said I could have 2 days. That was before you allowed a nun to get the better of you. The Belgians are going to start screaming shortly. Getting you out of there seems like a good idea. Something big is happening here. You don't know that. I'm here, on the ground, doing my job. I'm telling you that there's something here to discover. Something I need to find a clue on. They'd gone back and forth, and finally Reynaldo had agreed to honor the 2 days. But it was clear that he owed his boss a big one. Less than an hour later, a NATO chopper found him, and he was flown south to Perpignan, where he'd obtained ground transportation and driven the hour west toward the mountains.
Excuse me.
Where Sister Claire was headed with the body. Which meant she was most likely going to use the other way up. Fine. He'd allow her that. He just needed to be up there by the time she arrived. He checked his watch. That should
fudge
be soon, if not already. Assuming she'd driven straight through, which was a safe assumption. He'd managed to grab a little sleep on the flight south, having long ago mastered how to rest in snatches of no more than an hour or so. He bought a couple of sandwiches and a bottled water before heading over from town to the Abbey. The guy at the local cafe told him the hike up would take about an hour. Hope you have strong legs. Now, staring up at the start of the inclined journey, he could see that the man had been right. That was a long climb. But what the hell? He can handle it. Or could. Come on, Nick, let's go, Charlie Minter said. They were on an adventure. Nick, Charlie, and Marvin Royster. 3 12-year-olds in the hills outside Colorado Springs. Hiking, packs on their backs, boots on their feet. They'd done it many times before. One of the perks of living in such a wonderful place. The three had grown up together, their parents close friends. Today, they were explorers, following a trail above the timberline. Jagged, layered peaks capped with snow in the distance, only sunshine and green valleys in between. A beautiful Saturday afternoon. They were headed to the tunnels, originally carved out to transport ore through the mountains. Most were boring said that a wagon full of children had once been trapped there when the tunnel collapsed. So much damage had occurred that the entrance had been sealed, leaving the wagon where it sat with the bodies, trapping the spirits inside for all of eternity. A good old-fashioned local ghost story. My brother told me, Charlie said, that hikers have heard laughing inside the tunnel. He swears ghosts are there. Nick had heard the same thing from his older brothers, but he wondered how much of that was true, and how much was just them trying to scare him. My dad told me, Marvin said, that some people who've gone inside have been scratched by the ghosts. There are voices, and all kinds of weird things going on there, too. They had heard so many stories that they decided to go see for themselves. Hence, the adventure. The hike took about half an hour, the trail more like a narrow dirt road, well-defined with directional signage. No danger of getting lost. He spotted Beaver Lake off toward the west, its mirrored surface a shiny silver blue. Ghosts were said to dwell there, too. He'd read about a battle between the Cheyenne and Utes near its shores. Indians fighting Indians. Women and children had taken to rafts, trying to escape the carnage by floating out on the lake. A storm had struck, and they were all lost in the water. People said the lake was haunted by those who drowned, but he'd never heard or seen anything there. They were following the trail ever upward, the inclined path passing right by the haunted tunnel entrance. Imagine why. Plenty of room for a horse-drawn wagon to go inside. Nick had not expected that. My dad told me that they opened this up years ago, Charlie said. Nick was not as sure as he once was about the stories being false. Maybe there was something to it. You think we ought to go inside? Marvin shook his head. I'm not sure. Charlie slipped his backpack off. You're not scared, are you? I'm not scared, Nick felt compelled to say. And Marvin agreed. Me neither. Let's go in. Not yet, Charlie said. I brought some protection. His friend unzipped the pack from his back, reached inside, and removed a gun. Wow, Marvin said. Nick's eyes went
forward. 15 seconds. Forward. 15 seconds.
In the westerns. Charlie raised the gun and pointed it at a tree. We're ready now for whatever's in there. It happened fast. So quick that Nick never realized until it was far too late. Marvin reached for the weapon, saying he wanted to hold it. Charlie resisted, swinging the gun around and yelling no. The arc of his pivot pointed the barrel, only for an instant, straight at Marvin. But long enough for the trigger to accidentally be pulled. The bullet plowed into the young boy's chest, then exploded out from the back. Nick could still see the blood spray from the exit wound and the look of